Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will talk about the reactive forms validation. Reactive forms in Angular provide a model-driven approach to handling form inputs. This approach helps streamline validation by tracking changes to the form state and validating the input in real time. In this, we have form control states and properties. Form control tracks its own state and validity. Angular provides properties like dirty, pristine, valid, invalid, touched, untouched to help manage and validate form state. And this is our student info page on which we want to implement the validations. Validations we can implement on all kinds of form controls like form group, form array, and form controls. For now, I'm going to validate full name, email, and subject's name. So let's get started. This is our student info form, and here we have our full name, email, contact, and subject. And in subject, we have three more properties: name, status, and marks. First, I'm going to validate full name, and I want my full name is required. First, I need to write the brackets, and then in these brackets, first we have the values, and second, we need to write validators. And here we need required validator. Next, I'm going to validate email, but in email, if I want to implement more than one validator, then I need to write these validators in an array. So again, I need to write the brackets for array. In this, I'm going to write my validators. First is validators.required and second is validators.email. And exactly like this, I'm going to implement this validators.required on the name of my subjects. So this was the basic validation we implemented in our TS file. Next, we implemented in our HTML file. Before moving forward, for the sake of best practices, what we need to do, we need to write all the required fields getters so that we can access them in the HTML file easily. First, I'm going to write the getter for the full name field. Next, I'm going to write the getter for the email. Next, we need to write the getter for the name of the subjects array. We have already written the getter for the subjects, and now we need to write the getter for the name of the subjects array. And for that, I'm going to write this subject group. And in this, I need to pass the index. For this getter, we don't need to write this keyword get, because if we use this get keyword, then we can't pass the parameter. But here we need to pass our index parameter. That's why we are writing the normal function to get the name of the subject array. And it will return this dot subjects, getter of the subjects, dot controls. And we will pass the index at parameter here. And we will return it as form group. After accessing the subject group, now we can access our name property of subjects, and for that we will write another function, subject name, and in this we will pass the index of a particular subject, and it will return this dot subject group, pass the index, and now we can easily access from this group our name property. Dot get name. And we done our validation on TS file. Next, we validate our HTML file. And in this HTML, we also need to validate only these fields, full name, email, and name of subjects array. First, I'm going to validate the full name. And here I need to write the div. In this div, I actually want to show the error. First, I'm going to write the class error which I have created, and it will only apply the color red on our error message. And then I need to write this ng if full name dot invalid and full name dot touched, which means it will show an error if our field is invalid and has been touched. Now I need to write a second div in which I will implement another if which will check the type of the error. For example, first if we'll check either we have an error or not, And second, it will check the type of the error, and according to the type, it will show this message on the front end. And in this case, our error message will be full name is required. Exactly like this, we will implement our error message for the email. Now, in case of email, we need to show two types of errors. One is required, and for that, we will write the error email is required. And second is email. In this case, we will write the error email is invalid. And now I'm going to apply the validation error on the name field of subjects array. Again, in this case, I will write first div, and in this, I'm going to write class error. Now in our ngif, I will use the subject name getter, and in this, I will pass this index, and then I will check this both the conditions invalid and touched. In next if again we need to check our type of error, and according to that we need to show the error on the front end. Now let's run the application and test these validations on the front end. And this is our student info form. As you can see on initial load, it's not showing any error, but if I click on the field but not enter any value, then it will show us an error, full name is required. If I enter any value, like here I enter full name, then this error will be removed. Now if I click on the email field but not enter any value, again it's showing us email is required error. But now if I enter the value, email is required error is gone, but what we get now, email is invalid. So to remove this error, we need to write a valid email in this email field now. Next, we apply the validation on our name of the subjects array. If I click on this field but not enter any value, again it will show an error, subject name is required. If I add another subject and again click on the name field but not enter the value, it will show subject name is required. But if I enter the value for the first subject's name, then it will remove the error for the first one. And now if I enter the value for the second subject's name, and its error is also removed. So this is the way we can implement the validation in our reactive forms. As you have experienced, instead of adding validators to attributes in the template, in this reactive forms, we need to add validator function directly to the form control model in the component class. And then Angular calls these functions whenever the value of control changes. Hope you understand this entire lecture. Still, if you have any confusion or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.